You. 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 Pussy, Jigash, kitten, cunt, beaver, badge, cush, gully, crack, bush, bird, burger, kuno, kuni, cat, coot, click, clam, cock, cake, knick-knock, pum-pum, flap-fiddle, yum-puddle, coochie, kooky, coz and cabbage, cooch, cuzzy, cockpit, cockaliki and doodly-doo, churn, glue-pot, moosey, patch, rufus, bonnet, bum-butter and butter-boat, fish, monkey, punani, twang, twam, twinage, cha-cha, chuff, squelchy monkey, pole hole, pintle case, pin cushion, poopsies pink, poozle, and gachu, cutlet, cancan, pinkin, cooney, sleeve, booty, downstairs, you know where, knick-knack, paddywhack, bag for bone, ornament, squealer, growler, snitchit, cutlet and cooter, gear, quiver, quid, pooter, winker, oodle of boodle, pocket, rocket, socket, Snicket, bag of tricks, salami sack, and sausage wallet, box, squeeze, and lunch. Jig, jiggy, vajiji, vajay, jj, kooji, p, ace, ace of spades, abc, jazz, jenny, jelly roll, shot locker, mole catcher, rag tool, and election box. Muff, McMuff, Pokey, Chink, Long Eye, Weather Gig, Canister, Alley, Poons, Poonie, Peace, Pitch, and Parking Lot. Pranny, Poot Nanny, Pen Wiper, Mons Meg, Pipeline, Fly Trap, Mouse Trap, Clap Trap, Carnal Trap, Mangle, Mill, Bucket, Mum and Pup, AMP, Supermarché. Groan and grunt, hole from which I holler, circle and notch, nuki, needle case, poontang, puddentane, beef and beehive, futz and fuzzy, fuzzy, wuzzy, cat's meat, yum, yum, cream jug, scat, rooster, rat, fur, furrow, fern, slot, snap, stout, flap, fluff, pundle, prat, velvet and stage, hey, nanny, nanny, jing, jang, jam, pot and lollipop, pancake and sugar bowl, cabbage patch and bacon hole, dripping pan and gashy, gravy maker and gumbo, honey altar and devil's donut, salt shaker, money maker, fur, finger hair, oh my cherry pot. Holy pools of grindstone, nose bone, axe wound, bell chose, twirly whirly, Gigi's gal for yank, doodle, gully, damp, ditch, drip, gapper, gutter, gap, gasper, gimme, grotto, gusset, groove, gitch and dash, shaft, ras, bore, drain, a badget, civet, cushet, stuff, stank and skunk. Fireplace, milk shop, figlet, seminary, cash and carry, just dumb, cunnikin, jigger, none such and holy jack nasty. Tun tun, trim, quiff, quimsy, hoop and stage, grommet and grummet, quitch and lame, dew flap, main vein, fuzzy cup, drain, chinchilla, mink, mountain of mine, taint, meat, curtains, sin, cover, treasure, bit and caboodle, eel pot, pot of gold, alcove, waste pipe, love, tunnel, canal, muscle and cave, lacuna, cock in, cum bucket, ingle nook, sainted netch, notch, joint, cleft, split, poonage, spelunkin, glamity, cointy, lotus, vink, Venus, Pocahontas. Purse, yawny, fruit cup, honey pot, puddin, pie, hogstye, pooter, puka, placket, popo, quim, quinny, nappy dugout, lasshole, pigeonhole, porthole, manhole, mousehole, hole of holes, tuzzy muzzy, snack bar, stew pot, bearded clam, bearded oyster, bit of fish, cod, trench, fish taco, kipper box, periwinkle, trout, welt, split kipper, lap flounder, and fish mitten. Mom, mother of all Masons, mother of all souls, mother of St. Patrick, mother of Venus, Venus's highway, Venus's mark, certificate of birth, spunk pot, oracle, twat, tail, tuna, sardine can, snap, snatch, slice, slash, red eye, pink, undertaker, stink, lickety split, bite a bit, fuzz split, rosebud, and mother dear. When she got in the car, appellant said, "Bitch, my name is Genius. Damn, you are a drunky shit, as one of your friends is shit. Whoops, never mind, what a friend you got. Fuck, don't worry, bitch, your name won't come out of my mouth. You say it's a hoe's name, and I don't like hoes. So just let you know, you see a fat bitch. Let me tell you something, so get over it, bitch." Romeo said, "Tell me where the bitch ass is." Romeo told appellant to get that bitch. She slapped him, tried to scream. They fought. He said, "Shut up, bitch." He had a heavy Spanish accent. At some point, he was on top of her, strangling her with one hand, his knees on her diaphragm. She gave up fighting, believing he was going to kill her. It was 3 a.m. Appellant had a gun in his hand. He grabbed her by the ponytail, pulled her out of bed naked. Appellant said, "Come on, bitch," and pulled her out of the motel, dragging her across the balcony, dragging her down the stairs, and forcing her to his pickup, which his friend was driving. Once inside, appellant removed his coat and hit her in the back with a steel pipe, repeating, "I ought to shoot this bitch in her head." When he realized she was speaking nicely to him, he said, "If you're trying to be smart with me, don't try to use your psychology shit on me. If you're trying to be smart, I could kill you right now. You know that, bitch." Appellant also gave his friend some rock cocaine. The friend asked her if she wanted to get high with her. She said no. Appellant said, "You know, bitch, yes, you is," and made her smoke from the pipe after his friend. She was briefly unconscious after hitting the ground, but remembered hearing "fucking bitch" and the car turning back. She next heard a man's voice saying, "Bitch, get up in that bed. Oh, you gonna take your time getting in the bed?" The man sounded angry. A woman said, "Oh my God, okay, okay, okay." The man reiterated his directive to get into bed and said, "You gonna take your time getting in that bed?" She also heard the woman say, "Stop pulling me like that." She closed the door and appellant sped off, calling her a stupid bitch and telling her she'd already chosen up and was behaving totally out of pocket or disrespectful. He told her to crawl to him. She did. He told her that a good bitch would never lie to her pimp and she was going to be his loyal bitch and obey him and make money for him. Appellant slapped her face, first on the right side, then the left. She began crying. He said, "Real bitches don't cry," and punched her. He punched her whenever he saw a tear to teach her not to cry. She pulled her face to his crotch and forced her to orally copulate him for 15 minutes while telling her she was going to be his slave, to obey him, to be a good white bitch and make him lots of money. Appellant told her to get on the bed on all fours. She said, "No, please don't do anything to me." When she tried to come up for air, appellant would push her back down using both hands and telling her to continue. He ejaculated, saying, "Bitch, you better swallow that," and she did. According to her, he was my world, he was my daddy. She believed he would give her the world. She was meant to be with him, to be his good, loyal bitch. I was a good bitch. This made her feel important. She also wanted to believe appellant's talk of getting rich, though she also wanted to leave on a daily basis. If appellant referred to as a bitch, it was not personal. To appellant, every woman is a bitch. Childhood. One is not born, but rather becomes a man. No biological, psychological, or economic fate determines the figure that the human male presents in society. It is a civilization that a whole that produces this creature, intermediate between male and eunuch, which is described as masculine. Only the intervention of someone else can establish an individual as an other. Insofar as he exists in and for himself, the child would hardly be able to think of himself as sexually differentiated. In boys, as in boys, the body is first of all the radiation of a subjectivity, the instrument that makes possible the comprehension of the world. It is through the eyes, the hands, that children apprehend the universe and not through the sexual parts. It is in this perspective that the behavior of the child must be interpreted. In carnal form, he discovers finiteness, solitude, forlorn desertion, and a strange world. He endeavors to compensate for this catastrophe by projecting his existence onto an image, the reality and value of which others will establish. It appears that he may begin to affirm his identity at the time when he recognizes his reflection in a mirror, a time that coincides with that of weaning. His ego becomes so fully identified with this reflected image that is formed only in being projected. Whether or not the mirror actually plays a more or less considerable part, it is certain that the child commences towards the age of 6 months to mimic his parents and under their gaze to regard himself as an object. He is already an autonomous subject in transcendence towards the outer world, but he encounters himself only in a projected form. It is more satisfying to deny the anguish than to rise above it, more radical to be lost in the bosom of the whole than to be petrified by the conscious egos of others. Carnal union creates a deeper alienation than any resignation under the gaze of others. Enticements and showing off represent a more complex, a less easy stage than simple abandon in the paternal arms. The magic of the adult gaze is capricious. The child pretends to be invisible. His parents enter the game, trying blindly to find him and laughing, but all at once they say, "You're getting tiresome. You are not invisible at all." The child has amused them with a bright saying. He repeats it, and this time they shrug their shoulders. In this world, uncertain and unpredictable as the universe of Kafka, one stumbles at every step. This is why many children are afraid of growing up. They're in despair if their parents cease taking them on their knees or letting them get into the grown-up bed. Through the physical frustration, they feel more and more cruelly the forlornness, the abandonment, which the human being can never be conscious of without anguish. The detective introduces himself, says he wants to talk about what happened with Appellant's nephew. The detective says that when men do something wrong, they ask for forgiveness. Appellant asks for forgiveness. Appellant asks if the judge could send him to Mexico. He's thinking about his kids. He says he'll never come back. He doesn't understand his body. Asks for forgiveness. Asks it for his kids. She says he was thinking about killing her. He says he doesn't want to keep fighting with her. He asks her whether she loves him anymore. She says she does not. She asks him to admit what he did to her. He says it was a mistake and asks for her forgiveness. She wants him to apologize. He said he told her mother that he was sorry. Appellant says he would have liked to face Celeste and ask for forgiveness. Elena asks if Appellant is sorry. He says he is very, very, very sorry, but doesn't want to tell anyone. Appellant says he's really sorry for everything. He didn't take care of business right and is stupid. Mitchell asks what Appellant would say to Blakey in 15 years' time. Appellant says she's sorry for hurting you and that she loves you so much. She's sorry for lying and says what she did was stupid. Appellant also provided a written statement which said that he requested Josefina and Inez's forgiveness with all his heart. Appellant's letter said that he had been told she felt bad because he never said sorry to her. He asked her to forgive him and to tell her mother to forgive him. He writes that it was not his intention to hurt Tamara and he never thought it would make her feel bad. He says he loves her very much. He writes to his partner that he loves her and asks her to forgive him. He says he loves all of them with all of his heart. There is a smiley face drawn at the end of the letter with a balloon coming from the smiley face saying, "Sweetie, I love you, Dulce." After the signature, he wrote that he hoped they would forgive him. Appellant asks for forgiveness. He regrets what he has done. The detective asks Appellant if he wants to write that. Appellant says he does not know how to write. Athens, this is Rockfield. Couple of things. Hey, also, are you trying to get through to company on the American 11? We're trying everything here. Has he really got no transponder? Screw up or what? It appears that way. Okay, bye. Okay, so you don't know who the one, who the third one. Okay, what's the third one, the third aircraft? You guys don't know who. We believed it was a Delta 1989. However, when we asked him to respond to eight cars to land at Cleveland, he said he would. So therefore, I don't know if, and that's the one that they, I don't really know if he's a hijack or not. I really don't know. Okay. I can't confirm that he is. Okay. Do you remember when we were talking about the aircraft by, you guys have any idea who that aircraft was by the White House? Yeah. We thought for some reason to believe it was an American 11. I don't know if we heard that from somebody else, that they got a visual on him, that it was American Airlines or what. We just don't know. So we don't know which aircraft that was. We have three call signs. We don't know yet what that third call sign is yet. So we have two aircraft in the towers and one in the Pentagon, and we don't know what that third call sign was. You don't know what that third call sign was? No, we originally thought Delta 1989 was it, but now we have a third, possibly four aircraft. Are you still tracking that Delta 1989? Yes, sir, we still are. What, is he descending into Cleveland, appear to be? Right now, no, he's at 28,000 feet, 396 knots, still squawking his code, still squawking, yeah. He looks like he's by Toledo. By Toledo, doesn't it look like he's landing? No. Okay, no, he's at 27,000 feet at 27, yeah. Oh, then he is, sir, yeah, excuse me, I'm sorry. Where would he be right now if he was going to be landed in Cleveland? Would he be a descended? He would be descended now. He would be descended and speed would be slowing. Speed would be slowing. Oh, looks like he's not going to go there. Doesn't look like he's going to Cleveland. No, okay, yeah. I think an airplane just plowed in the city. Yeah, they did. The World Trade Center hit. No, another one. We just saw another one do it. Another one? Yeah. Holy cow, that's two. One just hit an hour ago. Yeah, one just a moment ago. No shit. Hey, Tony, are you still there? Yes, I am, Terry. Tony, I'm going to reconfirm with downstairs, but as far as the tape, but Bobby Jones seemed to think that the guy said we have planes. Now, I don't know if it was because of his accent or there's more than one, but I'm gonna reconfirm that for you, and I'll get back to you real quick, okay? Appreciate it. And what? Planes, as in plural. Tony, Terry, it's confirmed on that tape that they said we have planes. Giant Killer. Giant Killer's on. This is Huntress placing quit 2526 on battle stations, time 1310. Authenticate Charlie Victor, that is quit 2526 on battle stations. All parties acknowledge with initials, command post. Langley, Tower, how about command post? ODC, say it again, Giant Killer's out. No, the female, who was that? Needed? No, you're cleared to drop. Giant Killer, you're cleared to drop. Tower, you're cleared to drop. This is Panta 1. We need to confirm the ROE. And also, can you let us know if people are supposed to be flying right now, or is the ground hold still on? Panta 1 working. Okay, Smurf. Panta 1 is asking for current ROE. Where are we at? Where are we at? Can you tell him right now? Panta 1 Huntress, go. Panta 1 Huntress in the clear, currently at peace. I don't like your daddy. I still don't like your daddy. I don't give a fuck what he say, what he do. None of that bullshit. Your daddy is a bitch. He was just like, damn, I shouldn't have never come back outside. I should have just stayed. I should have just stayed in the house with my girl. And I was just like, damn, I should have just dropped off right here, took my girl before we came. And he was like, what I did. And I was like, I don't know. I was like thinking, like, I don't want it to happen to my mom. Like, I've been with my mom for like ever, and like, I don't know what I would do if I didn't have my mom with me. And like, if I could prevent something from happening to my mom, like, I would do like anything. Before when they gave me my sentence, I seen this nigga getting his shit. This nigga was so hurt, man. Bus, we was on the bus, and nigga was so hurt, like, we leaving, like, he getting out and we leaving on the bus. This nigga get off the bus and put his head down like he was hurting. Man, you good though? I dual boot W7 and Ubuntu. What does this say about me? I bought race-ready shorts. What does this say about me? I downloaded Neil Diamond's Forever and Blue Jeans from iTunes. What does this say about me? However, it would appear that my favorite songs on each album, respectively, are Blood Rush and Valentine, which are the songs about Chesters, and I'm wondering what this says about me, LOL. On a recent Caribbean vacation, I decided to relax, kick my sandals off, and snuggle up with a copy of Elaine Pagel's The Origin of Satan. What does this say about me? I like watching films about gladiators. What does this say about me? I grew up during World War II and was 10 when it ended. I've always loved submarines, stealthy, dangerous, and I suppose phallic weapons. What does this say about me? I don't take failure or defeat easily. If I'm not able to accomplish something, I get really upset and feel really stupid. Also, if I lose at something that I practice hard for, I get really upset and feel really stupid and incompetent. I'm very competitive in things I take seriously. I have a strong desire to be accepted by people, especially girls. Sometimes I fear doing or saying the wrong thing, so I avoid interaction with people. Sometimes I get really upset when I see a pretty girl because I think I can't have someone like that. I want people to value me and see me as an important person in their lives. I want people to respect me for being good at things. So what do the above things say about me as a person? I require constant praise and positive affirmation, or else I start questioning my self-worth. What does this say about me? Self-promotion is for losers. What does this say about me? What does this say about me and the kind of person I am? I always feel guilty for talking about myself, like I don't want the focus to be on me. I mean, I want people to know if I'm sick or something, but I don't want to be the one to have to do the telling. What does this say about me? That I want recognition for a job well done, some kudos, some attention? Yikes, maybe I need to see a therapist for this insecurity, LOL. Evidently, he has way too much time on his hands. And what does this say about me? What does this say about me? Perhaps I have more time on my hands than I initially think. Is taking 6 years to complete an undergrad degree too long? And what does this say about me? So what does this say about me? I'm a flake who can't hold a job. I'm an Aquarius. What does this say about me? I'm a Cancer with Libra rising. What does this say about me? Me, day, female fire, red snake. Month, male fire, red monkey. Year, female metal, white sheep. What does this say about me? So what does this say about me? Every stray cat and dog always comes to my door. When I lived in a house, now I live in an apartment on the second floor. There are always stray cats at my door. I prefer to stay home when friends are over. If I bring a girl over, I'd much rather stay at my house than go out somewhere. What does this say about me? What does this say about me? I am troubled. Actually, I am smiling. For some reason, a movie atmosphere indulges my mind quite extremely. It's like the atmosphere of a movie replaces the natural atmosphere I have in real life. I think more people experience this, but I have a feeling that I experience this more stronger. I mean, I have a feeling that I can lose myself in this. I really don't like when a movie presents a negative atmosphere. It always takes for me some time to get out of this. What does this say about me? Am I a fantasy person, an emotional person? I really don't know and can anyone explain this to me. The identity conversation, what does this say about me? Am I a good person? Am I worthy of love? And am I competent? So what does this say about me? Do I have the political and cultural equivalent of gender confusion? What does this say about me as a man? And what will other men say about me? Well, my dad is a Finnish person and my mom is a Vietnamese person. What does this say about me? What does this say about me? My favorite color is purple, but I also really like all others. This one just sort of draws me to it. I also really like fairies, Pegasus, and unicorns, along with roses. I also like glittering graphics, and basically anything that's bold, which includes that already listed. What does this say about me? Perhaps I'm attempting to use color to prevent encounters from degenerating into lies. Back to the point, what does all this say about me? I'm a little obsessive. I go all out or I go home. I find myself siding with the alien invaders and against the president, even though the human race might be wiped out. What does this say about me? Am I against the human race? Do I have some kind of hidden prejudice against having a black president? I hope not. In the aftermath of trauma, survivors often wrestle with the question, what does this say about me? The truth is, we tend to get what we expect. I always feel the need to sex up my Halloween costume in order not to blend in. What does this say about me? But what does this say about me? Am I destined to be a slut? What does this say about me? Do I not know or come in contact with enough women who are in order to make a choice or have an opportunity to pursue a relationship? But what does this say about me? Am I a cuckold? Might this change be the malignant product of a period of low self-esteem? Here's a crazy thought. I've been kind of confused lately as to whether I'm actually gay or not, or if I've just convinced myself I'm straight. I have realized that I'd be extremely pissed off if I were straight. Does that make any sense to anyone? Has anyone ever felt this way? Am I crazy? I was ashamed about it because I thought I'm supposed to be the healthiest woman in the world. And what does this say about me if I can't have kids of my own? What does this say about me? I'm still figuring it out, open to any conclusions you may have. Love and compassion are necessities, not luxuries. With each point you write, ask yourself, what does this say about me? All my characters are depressed, angst-ridden failures. OMG, what does this say about me? I think my character is turning out to be a bit of a narcissist, and this is beginning to bother me. It bothers me because what does this say about me? So what does this say about me? It says I can't let that first draft go until it's exactly how I want it. I've been compared to a character multiple times. What does this say about me? But if these are the sorts of stories that I celebrate, what does this say about me? I experienced almost complete suspension of disbelief. What does this say about me? Before posting anything, ask yourself, what does this say about me? I really enjoyed your offer. Grammar. It says more about you than you might think. What does this say about me? I hope you choked to death on a flavored condom. Question for the reader. What does this say about me? Augustine's method calls for reflection on my experience and asking the question, what does this say about me? What was going through my mind just before I started to feel this way? What does this say about me? What does this mean about me, my life? What does this say about me? What does this mean about me, my life, my future? What does this say about me? Will I ever get better? What does this say about me? Am I a total freak of nature? What does this say about me that I was willing to make this decision without anticipating these compelling reasons? Which is more me? What does this say about me? Am I confused, as has been suggested? What does this say about me? Because really, it's all about me. What does this say about me, and for that matter, you? Why should we care? I've never heard of half these people. I find the fly on the wall thing so fascinating. What does this say about me? A great question to ask in any moment is, what does this say about me? I am always bored. What does this say about me? What does this say about God? What does this say about me? Is it normal for me to get turned on by chasing down and killing people slash animals in video games, usually by kicking or stabbing the victim in the end? I get erect in the chase when stalking my target and walking slash chasing the target on a game. But it's not even like part of the mission. I just enjoy it. I even ejaculate when doing it, sometimes once or twice. Disgusting, I know. What does this say about me, and what should I do? What, that metal, perhaps, you think so, there is a reason, you think so, what, nothing, not that, again, 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 it is metal, no, it is time, no, it is time, no, it is time, no, not yet, later, when, later, how will I know, you will know later, bone then, yes, black, yes, now, no, it isn't time, now, no, is it time, no, there's no reason, not yet. Ice, perhaps, perhaps, too hot, what's that, what, that, the eye, yes, is it true, yes, it is true, is it good, yes, it is good, is it likely, yes, it is likely, is it time, no, when, later, when it is time, now, no, when it is later, when it is time, glass then, yes, do you see, yes, that, no, not that, it is time then, yes, how do you know what, no, when it is later, it is time, then, not now, later. Later, when, yes, when the black turns purple and green, when the music stops, when sound ignites to silent, when I cannot, when we become, when there is an unbearable, when there is no one left who is not, when we are less bloody, when we are thick with comprehension, when we witness today, when we see tonight, when we will, when we break all our fingers inside our mouths and swallow all our teeth, when we spare no one, when we slit our wrists to our necks, when we spare everyone else, when we are rich with hope, when we dance and dine, when we cradle and croon, when we cover ourselves with white butcher paper, Reaper, when we drink the tar of our wet, tangled streets, when we are, when we understand, when we bear our unspooled bellies and pink our unstrung throats, when we tear off the lash and the lid and rotate our bald eye inward, when we are understood, when we are we, and when we can become, when we will understand, when we will then, when we will win, when it is not my fault. Thank you.
Site sur lequel vous pouvez vous inscrire à notre liste de diffusion. Merci à tous, merci encore à l'équipe du programme FMR. Au revoir.